once you get to level 60, you don't get any more ability points. You just get crystals, which you can use to buy, well, not buy, to unlock these bad boys, which are useful because this is the only way you can communicate with people. Yeah, they're funny. The intros are interesting. 90% of them are super cheesy and look really dumb. The only two that I really like are this one. And this one. I like the little hip shake there. That's the one I got on my PS4 version. Because all of them are just so... They look like someone who doesn't know any martial arts trying to do stances for some reason. Even though they have the combat down so nicely. I was talking to my brother Sam the other day about how all of the moves actually look like someone who knows what they're doing is performing them. Maybe they recorded people or something, I don't know. But the intros, not so much. You can also use fragments. Is, should I go to the hunting ground? Or the hunting path? The harbor? Or the tower? Go to the hunting ground. Hunting path. Hunting something. This is where it'd be nice to be streaming and actually have people watching, because then I could ask them and they'd tell me, and then I'd probably do the opposite. My brother Isaac's always complaining that whenever I ask his advice when he's watching me play, I always just do whatever I was going to do anyway. Which is true most of the time. But that's not because I don't appreciate his input, it helps me make my decision. Look how pretty this grass is. But yeah, it's pretty. Little circles. Well, first of all, this is like a treasure chest, but it's a cairn. The little circles are me gaining experience with the different moves. of sad if there was just no one playing. I suppose it would make sense, but you know, just want to have people in the game. Such a cool game. Do some more endurance. Because I keep running out. See if there's anything I want to equip. I prefer going for more mobility and less defense in general. Because I just like to be fast. It's really useful in 3v3 because you can run faster. Because the 3v3 is a sort of a king of the hill kind of thing. There are zones, and you capture the zones by being the only one in them. Oh boy, here we go. Was he the one that I just fought? He's not, right? Two invitations. Oh, no, okay. That's cool that you can do that. Oh, so you can do just complete co-op. That's really cool. And you have a friends list. Oh. This is the guy that destroyed me, I think. Yeah. Oh, he's a mentor. Wait, no, he's not a mentor. He's got a mentor. I should probably close that door.
Just in case the house starts getting rowdy.
I need to tape up those Ethernet cables. Maybe I should do some more combat trials just to get experience, level up a bit before I try and fight the boss again. And maybe I should have gotten a different ability. That would be more helpful. Yeah. It's still kind of cold in here. I'm still cold in here. I should put on some defense just for this fight. Because I haven't actually been able to tell how much it slows you down on a 1v1. It's mostly just noticeable on running around. Come on! Frick! He's rough. I'm probably supposed to be a higher level before I fight him. But who buys into that crap, right? I'll just go take down these guys once again, and then maybe I'll have improved. So that move where I turn all icy looking, that's a charge attack. Whoa. Oh, what's this dude doing here? He looks tough. He's wearing clothes. Good clothes. She keeps hitting her allies. If he draws a weapon on me, I'm gonna be ticked. Oh. Charge attacks. You can get hit once, as long as it's not by a red or a lava looking attack, and you'll still keep going with the attack, which is cool. Oh, he just freaking drew a weapon. And there's another one. Hold on. One at a time. Yeah. How can she have two swords? Yeah, me. That was like one level though. Oh, I want that. It's probably because there's some tough fella here with me somewhere. I bet if I repair this, which I can't, if I did though, it would be decent. Alright, let's try this boss again. I actually spent a lot of time here on the PS4 trying to master the different combat styles. Because I thought the enemies here, since it's technically the first area, or maybe it's the last area? I'm not sure. Probably the last area, actually. Which would make sense why the boss is so difficult. Absorb ability. Which I use the right stick to activate. Oh boy. One at a time. One at a time. Come on, man. Where's your sportsmanship? Stamina while he's actually attacking me, just to, no, that wouldn't have worked anyway, just to absorb it. Maybe I should have started with a different ability. Didn't realize I'd have to use it for so long. Oh yeah, weapons, by the way, are cool because they'll actually cut through a guard. Even if they're blocking. And do just a small amount of damage. Oh, frick. Okay, good. Jeez. Dodging all over the place. I was close that time. A really easy way to take down the bosses is to just, if someone else is in the area, you just cooperate with them, and then fucking 2-on-1 the dude. But doesn't seem to be a lot of players online right now.
Yes.
Beta. Something I still haven't really talked about yet is my thought process this morning about how gaming in general is something I'm pretty passionate about. And if there were any game that I, for one thing, would want to go competitive in, but more so would be able to, well, I don't even know that, honestly. But it would probably be this one. Which you can obviously tell, judging by how easily I beat this boss. It's weird, it's different though. Playing AI is much different than playing other players. Frick, man. I need more stamina. And I need skills. I think I might go to the tower, just because I know that there's a skill there that would be really useful on this guy. It's called Shockwave. Would be the fastest way there. Probably back to the tower. Back to the tower we go. Might as well kill the guys on the way, get some experience. Boy, good movie. See that breaking symbol? That's their guard being, basically their stamina disappearing. Because the lava looking attacks, they do a lot of damage to a guard. That's why they call it breaking attacks. That was weird. I heard water, but then it just cut out. What's with that? Oh wait, no, it's not at the tower. It's at the harbor. It's Stu Harbor then. Hello. Man, I wish there were more people online. It ain't so bad though. One thing, one cool aspect about this game that you don't really see in any other game is the school idea. There are different schools and you can create your own school. And the way it works, that'll probably just be them, is that you set your deck, you make that, and then the people that are part of the school will unlock it by just participating in matches while having school stuff equipped, and then they can use it and learn the moves that you set up. It's pretty cool. Oh dang. I've never seen that one before actually. That weird ability did. Such a bad starting character for me, because my ideal would be to have any of the other three styles as combat ability. The reason I picked this one is because since it's the starting one, as soon as I can unlock a different one, then I never have to look back at this one. Mm-hmm. I can just be fast enough, then I can beat him. Not the best time to scratch my nose. I bet fainting could actually be useful on AI. Because it's not great on players, at least not the level I play at. But it might be useful on them. There we go. Oh yeah.